Yeah, sure, sure. So he's warning me just 20 minutes because he's wondering about cardiologist talking forever. I'm actually glad to be around. I think probably this is one of the dynamic, most punctual meeting I've ever attended, actually. I can't see in a Sunday, leaving all your busy practice, you're all sitting here, and whatever, you know, you get one day free and you're all here. I'm very grateful for giving me this chance, actually. So nowadays, we are treating lots of diffuse coronary artery disease because you're finding lots of people who have diffuse lesions. I used to work abroad, actually. Usually, focal lesions are very common, but in Indian patients, the diabetic population, older age group, even in younger age groups, you see lots of diffuse lesions, actually. That is a reality nowadays. And you have, the definition is very long lesions, more than 20 millimeters, if it is actually involving lots of arteries, multiple significant lesions and also significant lesions in the whole artery also we are seeing. Sometimes it's very difficult to both either to, or lots of senior people also here actually, it's very, I think they will understand it's even difficult to either do bypass or PCA also in these patients actually. So the management strategies could be medical management, which often I find is a good option also. Or if you can do even spot PCI, in particular areas, it is also helpful, or bypass surgery also helpful. So now you have the guidelines here. As you can see, three vessel disease with a low syntax score, still PCA holds good. Or diffuse disease with other lesions, also PCA holds good. So in these segments, so the syntax goes higher. That is, if the anatomical lesions are very tough, there is a bend or calcified lesions, often bypass scores better actually. So as I told you, older patients we are dealing with increased diabetes, complex lesions, more diffuse disease, increasing expertise also there to deal with these lesions now. Better hardware, we have an advanced stent designs. Now with the stent price capping, this is getting difficult now. We are only having the previous generation stents often actually. So PCA strategies could be either using a drug-eluting stent, putting long lengths, full metal jacket we call it, a biovascular scaffold, which again I'll talk to you about it, drug-eluting balloon lesions. Only balloon is used, no stents being done here. Or FFR guided fractional flow reserve actually. So we measure which is a significant area and treat that. And also imaging guided PCI. So we go for the full metal jacket first. There's been lots of, I presented this same topic in Saudi Arabia Heart Association last month. I was invited to do a talk. And they told, sir, this is the common lesions we deal with it here also actually. So Asians and Arabians, we find this very common. And it is often done. Usually it is not so bad. You have the restenosis rate only around 13% in about 1.5 years actually. Just imagine these patients without this still do very worse actually. So in that context, it's a good thing to have. Another study also showing similar type of, this is a longer term follow-up, 3 years follow-up. Target lesion, they go on to around only 20% actually, failure. So now, when you have used DES, use minimal overlap. You don't put lots of stents and overlap too much actually. Again, it causes problem. And you have post-dilate well, and then we use preserve the side branches if possible actually. So there is one case, 50-year-old gentleman with type 2 diabetes, single vessel disease only. So there is no talk about CABG in this patient. Long segment lesion, as you can see. There are lesions here leading on to overall everywhere actually. So in this often, if you want to bypass something, if you do something here, there is a lesion here also. So you can't really do much about this patient. Good medical therapy is an option, but the patient is symptomatic, then we want to do something. So after the course, consent of the patient, then we treat this. So you actually end up doing BCI. Probably three stents were used here, and you can see excellent results here. So the longer the length of stents you use, the chances of restenosis is slightly higher also. So you have to be mindful of that and counsel the patients accordingly. I think if you are truthful upfront with the patients, I think strategies what you do, do it on your conscience. You have to be clear that you are doing the best for the patient, and that is very important, and practice the guidelines. That's what I always follow actually. So in this patient, good results were obtained. Again, there is another case where one of the cases with CT was refused by the cardiac surgeons, severe triple vessel disease. such patients getting more and more common now. Actually, we get a heart team approach. We ask, we get the concurrence of the surgeons before we do such cases. This was done in upper line of Barkham. So again, diffuse lesions, severe LV dysfunction. Often, you have difficulty in treating this patient. I'm just showing this is a CTO case actually, chronic total occlusion. Occlusion is very old occlusion also actually. So here special hardwares were used. The wires are all very, difficult wires to use actually. You have to have expertise, otherwise you might cause complications. Microcatheter, this is a microcatheter used. And ultimately we crossed it after a long time. And often you have a team also actually. I have quite good colleagues working with me, Dr. Anand Yanaraj, myself, Dr. Bhupati. We work as a team, we don't have any ego clashes between us. And then you get excellent results out of it actually. You have a long segment diffuse disease often treated like this. Left also was done also for this patient. So now biovascular scaffold off late has had some studies showing slightly higher stent thrombosis or scaffold thrombosis. It has getting refined now actually. But it's actually a very good, I think that is the way we are going to go in the future. So the younger patients, it is quite useful because longer stents you use, often it dissolves completely after some time. You don't have any stents left inside actually. So later CABG option is there. Late, you often find the vessel sizes also increase actually after the stenting. Preserved function because there is no stent. And there is often quite good results actually from studies also. This is a 66-year-old gentleman, type 2 diabetes, recent acute coronary syndrome, triple vessel disease, not keen for bypass. And very diffuse disease, as you can see, disease is everywhere actually. Here. Where do you start, where do you end in these patients? Often in these cases, scaffolds are actually good in one way because you often, after 2 to 3 years, it completely dissolves actually. So you prepare the lesion well, and the end is a three scaffolds were used here actually. Yeah, lesions are fantastic actually, so you can see it's a fantastic reports. But often there's 5 years data coming out to be slightly more thrombosis is coming up in this because often the scaffold dissolves in certain areas, not dissolving in other areas, not endothelializing well. But the thickness is quite thick in these things actually. They are refining it to be becoming thinner now. So next, this is a fantastic result from this. Three scaffolds used post dilate well. So preparation, sizing and post dilatation. So CT angio was done as a follow-up for these patients and usually you find excellent results actually in the longer term. This was after 2 years after doing the case. Yes, drug-eluting balloon, often you find you can't put another stent, often there are various multiple layers of stent already available. So in these patients, you just use a drug-coated balloon actually. So you can see they often produce very good results in the 2 to 3 years data, very good. This is a 65-year-old patient, previous bypass. Again, within 1 year, the left internal mammary artery failed. So you have to do 2 PCAs to the same vessel, again recurrent angina. In such cases, you can't put another stent because how many stents would you do? So you can see there is a lesion here, haziness here, that is producing a problem. So in such cases, only balloons are used actually. So that's a balloon. And the balloon is getting, so the medicine is impregnated in that area and often it actually, after the results are quite good there, and after that medicine itself will not allow the endothelium to come back again actually. So you have to justify the use and you actually use it judiciously actually. So there is a CTO of the opposite side which we dealt with later in this case. So next is the same patient here. Next is FFR guided. So whenever there are multiple lesions, often you are fooled thinking that all the lesions are significant. You go and treat all the lesion stents. But FFR is one fractional flow reserve. You find out exactly where the lesion is producing symptoms or not. So you test the before and after. If there is a drop in pressure through the lesion, it's a physiological way of measuring. And then you actually treat only that area actually. So this is another excellent tool we have. There are various studies, FAME-1. FEM2 and FEM, and actually future, there is some negative from this trial, but lots of acute patients were used in this trial. So this trial was stopped prematurely, but two trials before that you gave excellent results. So we don't use it much in acute patients, we only used in stable patients. So if you actually think lots of patients are classified from angiogram, it's very significant. So high syntax score in 32 patients, but when you use FFR, you tend to reduce the significant lesions come down. All of them, most of them become only single vessel disease. and you treat only that disease. You don't go and treat all the diseases actually. So you minimize the use of stent and you make more physiological measurements to make sure all the other lesions are not producing any blockage or significant narrowing. So here you see this area lesion is there, this area lesion is there, this area lesion is there, and you do FFR, and FFR less than 0.8 is significant, 0.4, 0.3, 0.6. So you are just treating which area is causing that lower pressure. Pressure before and after is measured, and a drop in pressure means there is a significant drop in pressure. So that is the way we treat it. And often you have too many lesions in one row, then you say this is not significant, only treat the lower part, and that is good enough. And you leave that, outcomes are very good after 3, 4 years, 5 years, no problems come. So that is the beauty of FFR. Intravascular ultrasound again can be used. Lots of meta-analysis showing. So for this case, you have to have, there is a long segment lesion. You need to know exactly where to position the stent and all the length of the stent and diameter. So FFR is very useful in such cases. So you have physiological measurement by the means of FFR and iris by the means of measurement of these cases also. So you dilate them, and the measurement is done by means of intravascular ultrasound. And then you measure the where you should start and how, what millimeter stent you should take, and then you treat it actually accordingly. So long length of stents are need to be used in this case and producing excellent results. And you can justify the is it dilated adequately and things like that in this patient. So it's actually given, the time given is very short. IFR is another method where it's recently being used. Actually again it shows the physiological measurements. It's beyond the scope of this audience here actually. So thank you very much. Thank you.
Sir, sometimes reports restenosis is possible. In that case, would you advocate them straight away for CABG or you still do a trial?
Restenosis usually depends on what type of restenosis. Often imaging modalities are helpful. If there is a stent fracture, for example, stents can get fractured. Then often bypass is not necessary. You can just get that better. Often if it is diffusely again getting diffuse restenosis because of fibrous tissue proliferation, then there might be one more chance. You can try a different coated stent actually, and still you can give one more chance. Suppose the restenosis occurs in everywhere, then probably bypass is the best option depending on the patient scenario.
There is another option called, which I do, is called spinal cord stimulation. In these cases they are very useful, and this is a very simple surgery. I'm sure you heard of it.
Yeah.
So it's almost equivalent to a bypass surgery. The risk is much less.
It's all means of stimulating the endocardial blood supply. There are lots of things are there actually. So, thank you very much. Thank you. Time is okay now.
Thank you very much. Now I request Dr. Sridhar, past president, to give a certificate to Dr. Harikrishna Basu.